Oh, you multi embops. Ralphie here with Whisky Review 275 Part A. And thank you to Steve Shaw for the malt mention. Thank you for your patience, Steve. It has been rewarded with a real live vloggy malt mention. And thank you to everybody else, again, who has given me malt mentions to malt mention. Please be patient. It's a long list, but there's a lot of vlogs to go. So your patience should be rewarded at some point. Right. Now, I'm going to reward your perseverance in watching my whisky reviews by giving you some very practical advice when you're buying whisky at auction. Because it isn't simple. It isn't straightforward. It's like real life. It's just that way. That's just the way it is. There are fakes, there are pitfalls, and there are hazards out there, and you need to know about them if you're going to buy any whisky from eBay or online auctions or auction houses. Right. When you're looking at a bottle of whisky at an auction house, now it's easier at an auction house because you can actually see the bottle itself. You don't have that opportunity in eBay and on online whisky auctions because you're lying in the picture that they're presenting to you. But here we are. Here's a bottle of Checkers Scotch. Yep, Superb Deluxe blended Scotch whisky, no less. Now, I bought this at auction and it's authentic. And I'm going to show you what I checked with this bottle. Right, first of all, it's a cheap bottle. It didn't cost much. Therefore, it is not a target for serious fakers. They're going for the fancy stuff, the expensive stuff that makes them more profit. They're going for Macallans, Springbanks, Port Ellens, Ardbegs, big 70s, 1970s vintage malts. That's what the fakers are really targeting. But these little generic time capsule blends, they're not so bothered about because the money just isn't in them. And that's one reason why I buy these blends, because they're fun. And that's what whiskey should be. So, looking at this bottle, I'll hold it closer so you can see it. I believe this is genuine because the bottle's right. It corresponds with the dimples on the side of the bottle with the label itself. It's been stored in this box. The label's in good nick. It has the right information on it for the period of the bottling, 26 fluid ounces. There's no overprinting or smudging on the label, which could suggest a fake label. There's no traces of glue round the side where a fresh label could have been stuck onto a different bottle. Importantly, the seal, one of the most important places to check with any bottle of whiskey. It's got a little round medallion on it, a little logo that says Checker, and it's got three little turrets as part of the seal. And that is replicated in the embossed glass seal on the bottle. On the back of the label, the signature and the bottle number are, well, they look machine done. They're far too cleanly, particularly the number, it's too cleanly presented on the back label to have been written by hand or faked up. The signature looks genuine. I have, and I recommend you do this, go to auction with a magnifying glass. Look at it under your magnifying glass. John McEwen and Company Limited, Leith, Scotland. You can then go online and check it out and see if there's any other corresponding bottles. Importantly, ask the auctioneer. Ask them about the source of the bottle. They're there to help. Their business depends upon it, ultimately. Very important, I mentioned earlier, the seal. The seal itself is tight and flush and even against the bottleneck. There is no give. And don't twist the bottles, very gently check round the seal. Is it the correct one for the bottle? Is it fitting snugly? Does it appear at any time to have been loosened or replaced? I think this is a genuine bottle. Happy to buy it. It didn't cost me too much. I will enjoy it. It is not what they call investment grade scotch. Oh no, no. The speculators are out there, malt mates. They're looking to make money from the fashion for paying more and more and more for whiskey as a speculative investment. Whiskey should not be a speculative investment. I would refer you to the wine investment companies who are in Britain involved, some of them, in bad publicity. I'm going to pick my words carefully here. And it's a fact that has been mentioned on the BBC Moneybox programme, which is an absolute godsend to people who are trying to protect their cash and get advice. But tens of millions of pounds have been lost by investors in wine futures. And I see no reason why the same thing will not happen with whiskey. Do you know why? Because it happened before in the 1980s when a company was set up and apparently bought casks of whiskey from Speyside and then encouraged people to invest in them, and people lost the money. History repeats itself. Proceed with caution, malt mates. What else have we got? Screw tops. Got to watch with screw tops. You can have a wee twist in the screw top at the auction house here. Nice old centenary 1974 specially selected Scotch whiskey. Good stuff. Now, I believe this is authentic because seeing the back of the bottle, you might see that little dimple there. That should be directly opposite the label, because that little dimple holds the bottle in the cradle in the bottling plant, and then they apply the label on the opposite side. If that dimple is not opposite your whiskey label, you may have a problem. Also, there's a little bit of sediment in the bottom of that bottle. If this bottle had been refilled, that sediment is unlikely to be there. It would be nice and clean. I don't know what they'd be using, possibly Bells or something, Johnny Walker Red Label, whatever's in the supermarket. With screw tops, don't twist them in auction houses. Even if you do, if fakers have been using glue, there we are, Pritt stick, super glue, Pritt stick for the screw top, the upper section, to make it sticky and hold firm, and super glue at the bottom to hold the bottom perforated clamp in place. The only way to check that a screw top is intact with its little perforations is through a magnifying glass. Do not be ashamed to go through the bottles with a magnifying glass at auction houses. People do it and should do it. So there we are, an authentic bottle, proper bottle of whiskey. Look forward to opening that. The Malt Distillers Association of Scotland. I've never seen this before. I don't know what to expect. It'll be interesting. Next. 5th release, Port Ellen. This is a serious collector's speculative investor's malt whiskey. What you're looking for is the box as an investment grade scotch. The box has to be in good condition, no bashes, no bumps at the bottom. You really need this label here in the front, as it is in this one, to be nice and square on to the carton. The carton needs to correspond to the contents, and a clue's in the barcode at the bottom. So you can photograph this barcode and even send it off to the distillers. Perhaps they help you, may help you, perhaps they just won't bother. The bottle itself. Now, because this has been a recent bottling of Port Ellen, there is pictorial evidence online to give you a point of reference. You're looking for that green, slightly bowed, concave, convex, right, top of the bottle. Collectors are looking for neck fill. This is what you call a medium to high neck fill. If the line in the top of the whisky is dropped below the neck of the bottle, it suggests evaporation or alternatively a whisky that's been stored on its side. Do not store your whisky on its side. Store it upright. Wine gets stored on its side to keep the cork moist. Whisky should be stored upright. Simple as that. The information on the label, is the label on squarely? Yes, it is. Is the back label correct? Yes, it is. No signs of glue around the edge. Does the little dimple again here at the back of the bottle, does it sit directly opposite the label, which should be the way it is? And again, get your magnifying glass and check over the information that's there. Is there any overprinting? Is there any slight smudging? Is there any coloured parts of this bottle which doesn't seem right? I'll come back to this in our next vlog because I've got a surprise for you malt mates. There we go. As you can see, the top is all completely snug and tight against the bottle. It's hasn't been tampered with. So, when you are buying your whiskey, be aware of these things. You can't take things at face value. If you have a problem, your first port of call is to go back to the auctioneer. Now, this is an awkward one for auctioneers, because there's no reason why someone shouldn't buy a genuine bottle of something and then interfere with it themselves to try and get some kind of refund. It's, you know, some people are a bit twisted. So it's an awkward one, and it really is the responsibility ultimately falls on the shoulders of the buyer. So proceed with caution. Do your research, and you might want to do what a number of collectors are doing, and that is specialise. There are serious whisky collectors who are now saying, I will buy nothing but Johnny Walkers, or I will buy nothing but Bladnachs, I will buy nothing but Port Ellens, and they become specialists in that particular specific whisky area, whisky type, a single distillery, a specific kind of blend. And that's helps them, the specialists, the people that are spending thousands and thousands of pounds and dollars. It helps them kind of really get to know a specific history of a distillery, bottle stylings, signs of genuine bottles, signs of fake bottles, quite in depth. And it just needs to happen. It's a sign of the times. Anyway, I'm going to come back in Whisky Review 275B, and I'm going to show you fake whiskies, and I'm going to tell you why they're fake. Okay, okay. I'm going to share the experience with you so that you have the malt knowledge. See you soon, malt mates. See you soon.